Hello, on this video, I'm gonna show you how to save a value to a session variable and then how to retrieve the value from the session variable. I'm gonna be using ASP.NET C Sharp. So let's create a project for that. I'm gonna create a index page web form. And set that as a start page. On the index.aspx.cs file, on the page load, I'm going to write a value to the session. So session. And here is going to be the name of my variable, of whatever I want to save. I'm going to save something called user ID equals, and then just give it a value. So this value is going to be an integer. So the index page, all it does, it loads and then sends a value to the session. Very simple. I'm going to create a second page now. Add a web form. And then on the second page, let's retrieve the value from the session and then print on the page. So int UID equals session, and then right here inside, it's gotta be the same name that you set. And the name that I set was user ID. So I'm gonna copy this and paste right here. Whenever you read the value back from the session, you must cast it. So I'm gonna cast it right here. So now you have an integer back. Now let's just print to the page. I'm going to delete this form and I'm going to create a label. So going back to the code on the lblid.text equals my UID. So on my first page, let's put a link going to the second page. So from going to the index to the second page, so now let's run the program. This page is my index, and I have a link that goes to the second page, and the second page knows the value of the ID. So the whole point of session variable is that you set in one page and you can read that value in multiple pages throughout your whole program. Each browser will have its own session. So the values from one browser will not mix with the values from another browser. And another thing good to remember is that when you write to the session, you write in whatever data type you want, but when you read back, you need to cast back to your data type. And here, we could be using a string, but I wanted to use integer just to show you that when you read back from the session, you must cast it, otherwise it won't work. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. This is easy, and you can do it.